मैं फर गया नहीं ना हाँ फर
लोचे दिया शतादा लिख देखो
चलो चलो
try to yes try to have on the tables there are mandibles available okay this bone so at least three students for one bone at least three for one please so that everyone can have the access Okay. Enough, please. No video is allowed, please. Stop it. No, no, not allowed. Please stop it. Thank you. This is not from me. This is from deans and vice deans. This is not from me. Okay, please. Okay. Today we have to deal with three things. By look, if we see the objectives, they are very simple, like mandible and hyoid bone, cervical vertebra and intervertebral disc. But because the things are new to you people, so we will go slowly, okay? And it's going to be slightly long one, so stay with me, inshallah. We'll try to make it easy, inshallah. This is mandible, okay? Mandible is also called as the lower jaw or the jaw bone, okay? In the face region, there are many bones, thin, flat, irregular, but this is considered as the probably largest and strongest in the face region, okay? It has two parts, one is the body, this is the body, okay? And ramus, this part is ramus. So, one is ramus, two is rami. So it has one body and rami, two rami. So we can say one body and two ramuses, but don't say ramuses. Rami is the good word for two ramus. The body has an outer surface. Where is the outer surface? This one. Where is the inner surface? This. Or if I clearly see from here, this inner side, this inner surface. Then it has a superior surface which is called or border which is called alveolar border. This one alveolar means small holes, sockets for teeth, and lower is the base. This is the base of the mandible. Okay, so again, mandible has body and two rami. Then it has got an outer surface. The body has got an outer surface, the inner surface, the upper border, the lower border, or the base. Now, features on each, same, nothing new, body and ramus. Body, the outer surface, this outer surface. Symphysis menti, what is symphysis menti? Symphysis menti is half of the face of this, half of this bone develops from this half during genin period and half from this. When they unite, they make a midline structure like this, a midline ridge, slight elevation. This is cast symphysis menti. Okay, half from here they develop, and once they mix, attach each other, touch each other, they go slight more growth so that there is a slight ridge like structure here. This is called symphysis menti. If I follow the symphysis menti down, it will end into a small triangle. Look at your bones. If we see the midline, the lowermost part has a very small triangle. This is called chin. This one.
Chin.
It must be differentiated from shin. What is shin? Shin is this part of the leg. We will do in lower limb. But CHIN chin and SHIN shin. Don't confuse an exam with one harf and you are lost from here to here or from here to here. Okay? So be careful. Then is the mental foramen. This is the mental foramen on this surface. So only three. Three things are important here only. Symphysis menti, then a triangle chin, and here is the mental foramen. When in my slides you will find name of any foramen or content is written below in different color. So you must remember, this is the foramen, this is the content. Agree? With me? In all my this presentation, we have got one name with some different color.
What passes through the foramen?
What passes through it? What is mojood inside the canal or the content or the foramen? So inferior alveolar nerve and vessel is mojood inside. But this is the place from where the nerves get out and the blood vessels get out and supply the skin and cutaneous area. Before coming out, what they do? They give small branches to the teeth. And this is the innervation of the teeth. When we have certain disorders of these nerves or some irritation of these nerves, you can experience when we take cold coffee or very hot drinks, we suddenly feel a sharp pain. This nerve is this. Okay? So, on the outer surface, only three things are important. Number one, symphysis. Number two, chin and mental foramen containing this nerve and vessel. Clear? Okay. Muscles. You can see on your bones, which you, in your hands, some of the bones have blue and red colored demarcations. The blue and red, both are attachments of the muscle, but blue are insertions. In the previous book, you will find words as insertions. In the new books, you will only find as attachment. So, being clear for to you people, blue are insertions. Some muscle is coming from somewhere and its secondary attachment is on this side. So, here is the masseter, this blue one, big one, is the masseter. Then, here is the temporalis. Here is the buccinator. These are muscles of face, we will do them gradually. One big muscle here on the lower side is platysma. Platysma is a muscle which is from here to the clavicle, from here to the clavicle, subcutaneous type of muscle. Okay?
Can you differentiate between the primary attachment and secondary attachment?
You have to remember. Yes. If I ask you, if an exam, here is the deltoid muscle for example. Okay? Mm-hmm. This muscle is called deltoid. So if there is a question that give the attachments, so you must know that it is arising from clavicle, then spine, then scapula, and then inserted on the humerus, this part. So try to, for special groups, some groups of muscle, at least try to know. Okay, what these muscles are for? Temporalis and masseter are basically muscles of mastication, chewing, Arabic chewing.
Mouth.
Again.
Mouth.
Very difficult. Even more difficult than chewing.
Tahan.
Tahan is good.
Tahan.
Tahan. Okay.
No.
Tahoon. They have written sometime and they are giving you. Okay. This is muscles of mastication chewing. Now, inner surface. Where is the inner surface? This one. Okay. Inner surface of the body. We are only talking of the body now. Inner surface of the body. What inner surface? Inner surface has many structures. Let's start. Mental spines. In your bones, all the bones have a mismar here, a screw. This is the area for two spines, two mental spines. This is the front view. I will remove this and I will try to make the back view like this again. This is considered as the back view of the bone, like here. Here is the mismar. Can you find this?
Yeah.
Okay. If you remove it, in an actual bone, you will have two sharp elevations above and two sharp elevations below. Very sharp. In actual bones, you can find them. This is called mental spine. Where they are here? One and two. Mental spine. Mental spine, why mental spine is there? It gives attachment to two muscles. Genoglossus, genohyoid. One above to the above spine, one below to the below spine. See this picture first and you will find the concept. See, here is the spine, this one. Two spines, one here for one muscle to go to tongue. For one here muscle to go to hyoid bone. See this picture. This muscle from here is the spine, here is the spine. From here it's going to the tongue. Geno, glossus. Glossus yani tongue, lisan. Here is another bone, higher bone I will give you. And from here another strap is going here. So up geno glossus, down geno hyoid. Okay? Then, malohyoid line. Can you appreciate this line? This line is modulo here like approximately this and this. Mylohyoid line. Above the mylohyoid line, there is a depression here and a depression here. Okay? Above depression, submandibular fossa is the lower depression here. Sublingual, sub yani tahat, underneath, tahat lisan, sublingual, tahat lisan. Here is another fossa. So here is sublingual fossa. And here is submandibular fossa and the contents are written. Try to remember that. When we ask, what is this line? This submandibular line. What is the type to this line? Two muscles. Which? Malohyoid line, superior constrictor muscles of pharynx. Then, submandibular fossa, gland and lymph node. Sublingual, only salivary gland. Sublingual. There are three pairs of salivary gland here and here. Total six yani. One big parotid, then submandibular, sublingual. So three here, they are producing saliva, yani loab. Agree, Shiva? With me?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. No, no, I cannot go. Yes.
Mental spines.
Huh?
Mental spines.
Mm-hmm. At the place of Miss Mark, there are two small elevations here. One here, one here. From here, one muscle is going to the tongue, one muscle is going to the heart. Clear now? You have this?
No, it's not clear. Okay.
Because they have put a screw there.
Only the screw is there.
Oh yes. If we remove the screw, come here, see in the back. If we remove the screw, there is very small elevation here and a small elevation. From here, a muscle will come. From here, a muscle will go.
So, the above one, above the snare,
screw
on one below.
Yes, almost. Okay, clear now? Okay, alveolar border. We are still on the body, okay? We have done the outer surface, we have done the inner surface, now the alveolar border. Alveolar border has sockets. Sockets is these openings. Where the tooth is fixed, this is called socket or alveoli also, like lung. The same spelling. Total we have 32 teeth, 16 down, 16 up. Okay, they have different names. To start with, in the center, the one half of each side, this and this is same. Yani if I make a line here, this whole line is same as this line, this up line is same as this line, and all the names are same because they are 8 here, 8, 8 and 8. So 32. Okay? So first central two incisors. Then a long one is canine. Have you seen lions and tigers and cats? They have a very big Draculas which have. So this is canine. Then two premolars and then three molars. It is not necessary to have all of these in all the persons. The last one, the wisdom tooth, is likely to come out after 25 years of age, but doesn't mean that the wisdom is also coming after 25 years. Okay, sometimes it comes earlier, sometimes it never comes.
Yeah, exactly.
So the tooth is coming but the wisdom is not there, so be careful. Two incisors, canines, premolars and molars, all here, here and on the above, same. Agree? Any question up till now? Okay, lower border. Where is the lower border? This one. Base of the mandible. Okay. Investing air of deep cervical fascia, deep fascia of the neck. Then, digastric muscle, not to the whole extent here, in front, small part here. And platysma, you know, is a subcutaneous muscle going to clavicle from here, going to clavicle from here. And if this is the picture of platysma. From base of the mandible to clavicle on both the sides. This is the attachment of the face. We have done with the body. Now we are going to ramus. Where is the ramus?
This
one is the ramus. This is the body. Ramus, this is the anterior part, so this is anterior border. This is posterior part, so this is posterior border. Upper border, lower border. When the body attaches to this, this is, for example, the side view of mandible. Okay, here is the ramus. We have got this side as angle, zavia, of the mandible. This is called angle of the mandible. See now, features. Again, come in. Lateral surface, where is the lateral surface of ramus? This one or this one?
No,
this one, the first one. Here is the lateral surface, and for this, I have to again go on the back to find the lateral surface. Agree? Where is the medial surface? Here is the medial surface, here is the medial surface. Anterior border, this sharp. Anterior border, posterior border, upper border, lower border, angle. Agree? Two processes arising from which border? Upper border. This triangle, coronoid. This, condyloid. Okay? Anteriorly coronoid, posteriorly condyloid. Again, see. This is ramus. Upper border, lower border, lateral surface, medial surface, anterior border, posterior border. One coronoid, one condyloid. Further. Posterior border? Kala, posterior border?
Victor, this word, Victor, chondroid, can you tell us about the meanings of them, Victor?
Coronoid means a triangular area. Condyloid means a head-like area. Head-like. This is like a head of the mandible. I will go to details, wait. Okay. Lateral surface is related to two structures, parotid gland and masseter muscles. Here is the parotid gland, here is the masseter muscle. Masseter and parotid. Okay? Parotid is the biggest gland for salivation, lower. And masseter is a muscle of? Yes, you feel it here. When you clench the teeth, here and here, a big strong structure, thick one, is the masseter. Masseter.
No, I mean the
gland we cannot feel. Until it is enlarged and big and inflamed. Okay, medial surface. Where is the medial surface? This one. This is the lateral surface, okay. This is the medial surface. See, mandibular foramen, this opening, in your bones, you have got a very good mandibular foramen.
Yes.
And here is a point that if I pass a wire in this mandibular foramen, it will open into the mental.
Mm-hmm.
So the nerve is entering from here and get out from here. Give the, yes. One of the students in the previous batch asked, Doctor, the foramen is very small, how it can have mandibular nerves and vessels? I said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can pass, I cannot pass here. So, they are going from this foramen and they get out from this foramen. Both the sides. Agree? Then, lingula. What is lingula? Yes, I told you the canal. Canal is what? A tunnel, a nafak. Inside. So if I pass a wire from here, it will get out of the mental foramen. So this is the canal.
So far we took two foramen. Both of them depend from this side.
Yes. Both of them are connected. Then lingula. What is lingula? Lingu, yani tongue. Lingula means like this. A structure protruded like a tongue. Can you see this bone?
Yes.
Small bone getting out like. This is lingula. This one.
Why it's supported?
See on your bone.
Why it's supported?
Why supported? Yes. It has attachment of this ligament. Once the ligament is strong, it will pull it and the lingula will be longer. Okay? Then, myelohyoid groove. Can you see this depression?
Yeah.
Not inside tunnel. This depression only.
Yeah.
This is myelohyoid groove. This contains myelohyoid nerves and vessels. These are different nerves and vessels from that. It means two sets of vessels. One is going inside and one is on the side. Yes. Agree? At least please get close to him. He's a very good boy. Get closer to him and find him. This is the medulla oblongata. This groove here is the nerve. Get closer to him and see. Okay? Clear till this? Upper border. Where upper border? This one. It has got a notch, mandibular notch. It has got a lower border here, which makes the angle, zavya of the mandible. No problem. Anterior border, this one. Temporalis muscle is attached. And posterior border here, parotid gland again. Yani parotid gland is not like this, it is also going on the back, right? Agree, Shiva? Clear with you? Any question yet?
But the temporalis muscle is in front of the anterior part, anterior side. It's not honest.
If you see this, give me this one. If you see this one, can you see this triangle with blue? And it's also going here. So it is the temporalis all attached like this.
What is this red one?
This is buccius. Okay. These all pictures are only the revisions. Temporalis muscle here, temporalis muscle here. Masseter, all the attachment, different attachments inside, outside, these are the revision pictures. Coronoid process, where?
The anterior.
This is the coronoid process. What is attached? Triangular flat process bounds mandibular notch anteriorly, clear. Laterally covered by masseter, here. Only covered. And what is attached here? Temporalis, you know, here and
along,
here all.
Along with the medius.
Yes, along with the anterior border. Anterior border. Not say medial, anterior border. Condyloid. Someone asked for condyloid. Head. Condyloid means head. Head process. Okay? After the head, head makes a joint here. Temporomandibular joint. If you open the mouth, you can feel the head. Okay? Then, neck. After the head, this small constriction is neck. Can you appreciate this triangular area? On your bones, there is a very good triangular blue area. Yes. This is pterygoid fovea and contains lateral pterygoid muscles. Good? With me? Or in the desert? Be with me. Again. Condyloid process, this head. After the head, small neck. Then there is a triangular area. This is called pterygoid fovea for the insertion of lateral pterygoid muscle. Yeah. What is lateral pterygoid muscle? Yes.
In the sphenoid muscle, in the sphenoid bone.
Yes, there are two plates. Medial pterygoid plate, lateral pterygoid plate, and one of the muscle, medial pterygoid and lateral pterygoid, are coming from there.
So
these are four muscles of mastication.
Yes.
Temporalis, no. Temporalis, masseter, medial, and lateral pterygoid. So these all must go to four. This finishes your this bone at least. Take a long breath. If any queries, bismillah, and then I will go to higher bone. We do not have to go into details of the higher bone. Just superficially we'll go. Just few parts and I will give you some hints. Any question? Okay, what is hyoid bone? Hyoid is a very small bone like this. Okay, no need to take the bone. Be comfortable, okay? This is, yes, a very small bone. Only we have to appreciate the parts and some things I will show you. This is the hyoid bone. Where? Hyoid bone is a C shape or a U shape bone. Where? Majud, this. See this?
Here.
Yes, see this? Yes, exactly. Here. This is the hyoid bone. Majud, where? A C shape midline structure like this. Okay? Here. Where is the hyoid bone? This one is the hyoid bone. Like a C fixed here. Okay? Now, between chin and thyroid cartilage, what is this? This is chin and this is thyroid cartilage.
Yes.
So between them. What level? If an exam, they ask you level of the Hyoid bone, so base of the mandible and C3 level.
Okay.
This is easy. Mm-hmm. Cervical vertebra 1, 2, and 3. Agree?
What's the function of this
chain? Wait. No other bony articulations.
Yes.
So, how it is attached? It is attached to skull and thyroid cartilage. Why? To skull with styloid ligament. Can you appreciate this ligament?
Yes.
Going where? This is mastoid process. This is what process?
Yes.
Styloid.
Styloid.
Styloid process. In between them is the stylomastoid filament.
Yes.
Remember?
Yes.
I told you probably. This is styloid process. This is mastoid process. So this is going to tip of the styloid process. So it is the attachment of the bone. Number one. Number two. Thyroid cartilage with thyrohyoid membrane. Not shown here. I will show you another picture how the bone is attached to the thyroid
ligament,
cartilage. Yes, one ligament, one membrane. Again, a ligamentous structure. No.
Thyroid.
See here. See, this is the four. This is to show you location of the bone. Now see here. It is attached here with this ligament. And here, you cannot see the membrane because they have removed to show the cartilage. But here you can see the membrane. Okay? So above it is attached here to the skull, and here to the thyroid cartilage. What is thyroid cartilage? Tufa al-Adam here. Adam's apple. Can you remember this?
Yes.
A very prominent structure in male larynx is Tufa al-Adam. Adam's apple, they say. See another picture for thyrohyoid membrane. Good? Marhaba. Okay, listen here. Sorry, this is hyoid bone. Attach where? Styloid process.
Yes.
Attach where?
Thyroid
cartilage. With thyroid membrane. Thyrohyoid membrane. This is anterior picture. This is posterior view. From inside. Yes.
Isn't there a thyrohyoid ligament between them?
A small thickening here sometimes is called as thyrohyoid ligament. But broad is the membrane.
Mm-hmm.
Very broad like. Okay? Parts. Remember this only.
Mm-hmm.
And one more slides I will show you. Don't remember each and every muscle on this bone because it's very difficult to appreciate on such a small specimen. And secondly, we cannot put a pin even. So, this is the body. It has two parts, corneum or the horns. This is lesser corneum or the smaller corneum here and here. And this is greater corneum.
This process is called?
Or the horns. Yes, this process is called. The smaller one is called smaller corneum. This is called greater corneum. See here, another picture. Can you see, appreciate these two parts?
Yes.
This?
The lesser one to the styloid?
The superior.
No, the bigger one. The bigger one to the styloid. This is only hanging. No attachment.
So where is that?
Lesser cornea.
Again.
This
one is lesser cornea.
Yes.
This is greater cornea. This is body.
The
from superior surface, from inferior surface.
Can we go back to the attachment to the styloid?
Yes, sure. See this.
Yes, the green cell will be there.
So there is an attachment with the C3, right?
With?
C3.
Yes, these are slight thin ligaments. But these two attachments are very important. Only remember these two.
Okay, exactly.
Hatch?
On the lesser.
Yes, this is lesser corneum. This is greater corneum.
Where is the attachment of the ligaments?
Here.
In the lesser or the greater?
No, the lesser or the greater. This
one
yeah.
To the lesser,
yeah.
And here the whole surface is attached to the
cartilage.
Yeah.
Where
is lesser?
This small lesser.
Lesser.
This longer.
The
lesser attached
to the
styloid.
Yes.
You said the longer.
No, I'm sorry. If I say like that, I'm sorry. Here, this is attached, and here.
Yes.
Agree?
Attached to the styloid.
Yes, styloid process of the skull. And the greater is free.
It's
free. Okay. All the big people are free. All the small people are working. Agree? Okay. Again, parts. See body? Upper surface, lower surface. Small corneum, big corneum, or the greater corneum. The best word is greater and lesser corneum. Okay. These two slides, okay, what is the relation of this bone? How, where is module? This is the location, this is larynx. So below is the larynx. Above is the tongue and mouth area. And on back, here, epiglottis and pharynx is mujood. This is our location, just to give you an impression, where is the bone. Actually, we cannot see it, we cannot palpate it.
What is this epiglottis?
Epiglottis. Epiglottis is this cartilage, is called epiglottis. This one. This is the epiglottis, which covers our trachea when food is going to the esophagus. One at one time. This is epiglottis. Clear now? This clear? Good. Again, some same fixed features, same parts. Nothing different.
Can't you palpate it?
We cannot usually. It's very inside, number one, because there are so many muscles, athletic fascia, fat. And very rarely it is, I will show you, very rarely it is fractured. What are the functions? I will give you. Give me 1 minute. Try to remember these muscles and these muscles when they ask what is attached on this bone. Just remember the names. These two sides. This. Don't remember the locations. This is fulan, this is fulan, this is fulan, this small, small, no. Just in case they ask you, this is which bone, you write hyoid bone. Name all muscle attached to superior surface. So write this, and if they ask name all muscle inferior surface, write these three. Okay, these muscles we will be dealing with in the neck region also. So wait for that. Up till now only names. Don't go into details. What is the function? Only assist in the movements of tongue, pharynx, and larynx. This is the helping bone here, working as a central point for different movements. This is the only function. Akid, the movement is because of the muscles. But it helps for their appropriate contractions. With me? Very rare case of fracture of hyoid bone. You cannot see until what is the cause. If a person comes and kills him like this, this is going to damage or fracture this hyoid bone. It's one of the very rare pictures you can get. And this is a very rare x-ray where you can see a fractured hyoid bone in a dead body.
First down.
Yes. Two things are finished now. Cervical vertebra we have to do now. Any questions still? We have? Any question? Good. What is this picture?
The vertebral.
What is vertebral called?
Has five regions.
Have five regions? What is this actually? It's made up of small multiple bones of similar shape. Arranged one on the other like this. Okay? With different size, different shape, and multiple joints. This all is called vertebral column. This is the anterior view. If I am standing like this, this is the view. If I am standing on the side, this is the view. And if I am standing on back, this midline is the view of vertebral column. What? Why this column is there? Two main functions. To carry the spinal cord inside. Number one. Again, the posture of the back and all the muscles of the abdomen and thorax region to hold the trunk, yani abdomen and thorax, to hold it like this. Okay? Has been divided into five regions. Cervical, seven small bones, vertebra. Thoracic, 12. Lumbar, 5. And sacral, 5. And coccygeal, 4. See, here has no separate bones. They have united together. So make a big bone. These three also have united. These four also have united. But can you appreciate these blue lines?
Yeah.
These are the discs between the bones.
Separated.
Like here. But interestingly, there is no disc here. There is one disc mojood here, and again there is no disc. Okay?
Disc for movement, huh?
Disc for movements, I will show you. And also for shock absorption, because bone on the bone is difficult to handle. Bone with some sponge-like structure, soft.
Compressed.
Yes, can be compressed, otherwise bone will break the bone. These are the features of any vertebra in the world. Body? Vertebral foramen. Yes, this is the canal for spinal cord. One is foramen. If we keep 33 one on the other, it will make a canal, namak. So spinal cord will be inside. This is pedicle. This is lamina. This is spine or spinous process. Same, no problem. This is facet. See different picture, you will appreciate the facet. See here. Again body. Transverse process. Spine. See here. One facet. See here. Another facet. So this vertebra will come and fix here with the help of these two facets, and above vertebra will fix here with the help of these two facets. See this picture. Wait. See this picture now. Where is the facet now? This is one vertebra with this facet facing downward. This is another vertebra. Here is the facet. So one facet from here, one facet from here make a joint mofacil.
Yes.
With very small movements, not a joint like shoulder moving like this. Very small gliding movements. Why? When I have to see on my back, which you people do not see while driving, is how I see on my back. Small movements of one vertebra, then another, then another, then another, then another, then another, and gradually I go my back. Okay? Try to check your joints this time. Before. Okay, no problem. Now, can you see this joint formation here? Similarly, one above, similarly one down, will make the joints, will make the column. Wait. Between the bodies only, here and here, is the disc. Not going here. Now where is the spinal cord?
Inside.
Spinal cord is inside. The spinal cord has to give branches. So branches will come out from where?
This
opening. Here branch, here and on that side also. How this foramen is made? Intervertebral foramen. How this is made? Initially in single vertebra there is no foramen. There is only a notch. But notch of this and notch of this will join and make a foramen. With me?
Yes.
Surely? Okay. This is intervertebral disc.
There is no opening with the disc for the spinal cord.
No. Disc is uniting the bodies very strongly. No, the spinal cord will pass here behind the hip. See this picture. See, go one picture ahead. Where is the disc?
Ah, in the body.
Yes. This is the disc.
Not in the canal.
This is the disc. So canal is free for spinal cord. So here is the disc. Here is the disc, or here is the disc. And the spinal cord is free to move from here.
So spinal cord is actually not covered.
Spinal cord has gone.
Not covered by bone.
No. Spinal cord is mojood inside here. It has got three other connective tissue coverings. Dura mater, arachnoid mater, pia mater. When you will grow up, we will teach.
Yes.
These are called three meninges. Now clear? Yes. How the spinal cord goes out? From where? Spinal cord does not go out. Wait, I will show you a picture. See this. See this picture. This is now. Now see. What is this? What is this? Body. This is this. This is another body. What is this?
Spine.
What is this? Transverse process. What is this? The Face. Joint between this vertebra and this vertebra with the help of facets.
What do you call it, sir?
Facets. Superior articular facet of this vertebra, inferior articular facet of this vertebra, joint and make a joint. Spinal cord goes straight and the branches get out of these small foramen. Agree? We have In third year, we have a separate vertebral column, whole class and lecture. Here we are not for this vertebral column. Here only we are for parts of the vertebra. So be careful and be comfortable for the parts only. And even the parts of cervical region, only 5, only 7.
There is no spinal in the first 6.
No, spine is from here, seven. Skull to everywhere.
Okay,
foramen transverse serum. Total 7, typical and atypical. Yeah. What is this typical and atypical? All of you people have good hair, except me here. Okay? So who is atypical?
You.
I'm atypical. If one of the students comes, all of them are in green. He is in black shirt. He is atypical. Another example. Clear now?
Okay,
yeah. What is typical and what is atypical?
Black one is typical.
Yes. This is typical. Whenever we go to Madhiram Navra on road, we always see this. If I say this, I say, oh, this is atypical. This is typical. Yani everyone is like this. Similarly, heart on this side is typical, atypical. Many ribs can be typical, atypical. Similarly, see here. This is a typical structure of our vertebra, cervical region. How many are typical? 3, 4, 5, and 6. What remaining? 1, 2,
7.
1, 2, and 7. See, this is near the typical one. 7-1 is very near to the typical one. This has no body. This is very atypical. What is this? So this is very atypical. So first, study typical size. What is a typical vertebra? Cervical region. Body, again vertebral foramen, no problem. Transverse process, with one foramen extra here. Foramen transverse serum. Why? Because vertebral arteries from here, subclavian will go to here to reach the brain and here to reach the brain. Vertebral artery and vertebral vein. Agree? Then, vertebral foramen for spinal cord, it has spinal cord.
Yes.
Lamina and spine. Spine is divided into, this is called bifid.
Where?
Bifid. This is called bifid spine. These are the features of a typical cervical vertebra. Now, like that camel, atypical. The remaining three, number one, also called as atlas. Number 2, also known as axis. Number 3, also called as C7 fuli or vertebra prominence. Why? I will show you. This is clear up till now? What now, features of each vertebra now. Wait. Huh.
What is the spine?
Spinal cord or
spine?
Which spine? Spinous process.
Yeah.
It's absent here. That is the reason they are atypical. Yes, that's the reason they are atypical. Wait. See here. Atlas, no body, no spine. Okay? There's no body. There must be a body here. There's no body. There's no spine. But foramen transverse serum is there. Good. Anterior arch, posterior arch. What is this? This is arch. This is arch. Then, important joints. The first vertebra, the first cervical. These two parts will have skull here. Condyles of the skull. You know, around the foramen magnum, there are two big structures. Yes. So, atlanto-occipital, that is the part of occipital bone. So, atlanto-occipital joint, it will make above here.
From the back.
Okay. And inferior, it will make a joint with second vertebra. Atlanto-axial joint. Why atlanto? This is atlanto. Axial, this is axial. Axis, name, atlanto-occipital. One very interesting thing here is noting yes movement of the head, like this,
like yes,
and below atlanto-axial joint, no movements of the head. In the previous batch, when we gave this question in exam, they said there is no movement. All the students came to me And I said that I have shown you there is a movement. The movement is no movement.
No movement.
Let's say no movement. So be careful. Movement is there.
But with
as a condition.
Yes. The condition of no is this movement. Condition of yes is this movement. Not clear?
No.
Don't be like the previous day. They say, Ya Doctor, you said there is no movement. Ya Allah. I said there is
Atlanto occipital for
yes. For yes movements, Atlanto occipital joint is involved. For no movements,
Atlanto axial
joint. Atlanto axial joint.
The axis for the second
position. Axis, yes. This is the feature of axis. This is a very unique vertebra. You will find a long thing getting out of it, like this. See, like this. Anterior view, posterior view. How? This is called odontoid process. They think that in the...
Helps on the rotation of the head, right?
Yes, exactly. They think that for the rotation of the head, and this is Mojood here, this is first one, this is second one, and previously it is thought that this was the body of the first, now separated and fixed with the second one. In development, it may be a body of the first one which has detached and come attached to the second axis. To the axis. See this. You really got it? Okay. Again. This is the first vertebra. Has no body. This is like this. Okay? The second vertebra has a body small and a process like this. So they were thinking that this part was the part of this vertebra with, because of the head movement needed, so it has detached from the first vertebra and has attached to the second. Now understand?
Yes.
See the features.
So it's originally from
mind. Yes, but don't remember it. It's just a maybe a takhayul or a very ancient thinking style. Odontoid process, this one. Spinous process, very small, bifid. Okay. Then important joints it will make above, same atlanto axial joint. Movements mojood or not mojood? Movement mojood.
No.
But no movement. So be careful. Below it will make a joint. C3.
C3.
No problem.
With the normal rotation.
Yes. So 1, 2, 3, you know now. 4, 5, 6, all typical. The 7th one remaining is this one. If I make, this is called vertebra prominence. Why? Because if I make the neck like this, I feel a very prominent structure here. This is the spine of seven. It has got the longest spine. Okay? See this prominence. If I make my neck here, is the most prominent area. You can feel it.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is the spine of 7th vertebra.
You have 2, which one?
C7. You have 2. So 7A and 7B. Longest spinous process? Spine not bifid. The longest spine is not bifid. Small transverse process, this with a foramen transverse. Clear? Good. This is when we see all of them together.
Yes.
Now, you can appreciate, what is this?
Axis.
Axis, yes. Axis. This is the part of axis getting out,
yes,
like this here. The odontoid.
Very good.
Odontoid. Yani tooth-like. Odontoid, yani tooth-like. So it is coming a tooth-like process.
The bifid is originated from the spine, right? No.
Not originated. See. Bifid is not a muscle.
No, bifid.
Bifid means
from the
all the spines of all other vertebra in the body are like this. Except cervical vertebra typical, which are bifid like this.
All cervical.
Thus, yes. But remember the shape of typical and atypical. See here. Not bifid, 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 bifid.
So the typical and one is
yes.
With bifid.
See,
isn't it?
See here, see here, see here. Again. All typical,
yes,
bifid.
Just a question. Now the spine. Wait.
Except C2, which is atypical, again bifid. Huh. Okay? So all typical and C2 are bifid spine.
Yeah. The spine is outwards, right? Like
towards backward. Backward.
So the omohyoid.
Don't go for omohyoid.
No,
it's
not. It's not, yes.
Odontoid. No. Come here. This is on the anterior aspect. See, this is the anterior aspect, this is the posterior aspect. So odontoid is on the hair and first vertebra is like here. See this picture. Try to appreciate this picture.
So the spinal cord moves with the head. Because it's
spinal cord. You can it is to prevent the excessive movement of spinal cord. When we hang a person, capital punishment, what we do?
Just split it out.
We split this head.
Which one?
This one, odontoid process.
From the
second axis. Take this. And it will go where? When you hang a person, it will compress, block, cut, damage and damage the spinal cord. And respiratory center is here, it will be dead. Okay.
What is this?
Spinal cord is okay. Come here. See. Where is the spinal cord?
Inside the foramen.
Inside the hair foramen.
Yeah.
Okay? This is only for the movement of the head, not the movement of spinal cord.
Okay.
When I hang someone, he dies.
This is backwards, right?
This is front, this is back. Spine is on the back, yeah.
This is the posterior view.
This is side view, rather.
Yes.
This is true lateral view. This is side view. This is three-dimensional view to show you this is on the side, this is the back, this is the front.
So it will go,
if I hang someone, it will fracture and go posteriorly. Here is the cord, it will break the cord, and respiratory center is here, he will die. Okay. Our last 5 minutes. Intervertebral disc. Elastic disc, shock absorber, makes 1/4 of the vertebral column because it's modulated in every vertebra. Except, it is not between atlas and axis. Not present because there is no body. Sacrum, whole of the sacrum bone, there is nothing. And coccyx, 3 or 4 last, there is no intervertebral disc.
And that's the last one. There is one also.
Between this and this one disc. Okay. Parts of the disc, 2 parts. One here soft, one here cartilaginous thick for protection. But disc is majud here inside. Before, the disc is made of fibrocartilage. A thin plate of hyaline cartilage is also majud to be in between, a sandwich like. Have you heard the word arkunnisa?
Yes.
But it is not only fixed to nisa. Agreed? It's also in male, arkurajal. It must be named like this, arkurajal. What is ark? Ark is sweating. So why sweating? Ark is pain?
There is arak.
Okay, this is
arkunnisa.
Ark
is sweat.
Yes, arc is sweat, I do. And arc nisa is the pain problem. So, see there. This is the spinal cord. From here the branches are going out. If the nucleus, the soft part or the hard part is damaged and there is a compression of this nerve, which is going on my lower limb here. Here is the compression. So I will have a pain all along the nerve. This is the reason of
arthritis. So
treat it, make it rest. If it does not improve, it rest. Don't cut the nerve, okay? Cut this part, which is compressing the nerve. Sometimes,
what's the term for it?
Term sciatica. Sciatica. Arkinesa is sciatica.
Doctor, some condition of this, doctor.
Sciatica. The King some Abdullah has probably just yes. done surgery.
Some condition in the curve.
Wait for the medicine and surgery people to teach you. Okay. At the end, I have given in this presentation certain slides which will help you all the names like this. With dots even. Okay? So, it is very helpful for you when you revise the whole stuff. Okay? Each and every thing. Each and every muscle. And I don't know, you people have eight changes of mandible in your objective or no? If there is eight changes in mandible, because there is only described mandible. So go to Dr. Masood, if he says there's change, I have written all the changes in mandible. Fetus, adult, birth, adults. Okay? If this is required, take. If not required, this is the common sites of fracture of mandible.
Thank you.
I'm sorry for taking it long. It is difficult stuff. But I have to make the things, very small things, so I have to make it clear. Okay? Thank you. Don't remember the typical and atypical camels. Okay. Who is the leader now? Please bring the
قول له نديف يا احمد شو اسمه ايه زين يقول وش اللي من جد تقول واحد مشتاق وش زينب 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 ايه احمد ليه ده زينب حاتم مشغال ولا مطفى خلاص طفيت
شباب شباب مره واحده ما راح اعيد ترى واحد اثنين ثلاثه اربعه خمسه سته سبعه
شكرا
ثمانيه تسعه عشره 11 14 15 16 17 20 22 22